This is the SAP Developer News for May the 29th, 2025.
Hello, ABAP developers. The ABAP release of 25.05 happened last week, and I'm here to highlight some of the key features. Firstly, reduction in the technical downtime during the release upgrade, which is great to keep your business process running. Secondly, in ADT, there is a new wizard called Quick Fury Application Generator, which will help you to generate Fury project within ADT itself. You need not have to log into Business Application Studio or Visual Studio Code to create a Fury project, but it is integrated with the ADT. A video about this feature will be available coming Monday in our SAP Developers YouTube channel. And thirdly, and most important one, AI in ABAP. In the AI space, I want to highlight three things. First, JuChat is now integrated in ABAP Repository Object Generator Wizard, which will help you to generate OData UI service from the scratch just by using natural language prompts. Second, unit test is quite important, and you can now use a prompt to generate ABAP unit test methods. Third, the prediction of the code completion has been enhanced. There are other features related to ADT, OData, CDS, which is described in the blog post by Nora Klepp, which is in the description. Do check it out.
Decisions in SAP Build allows business users to create business rules for approval policies, pricing logic, legibility check, etc. within a process automation project. Until now, even the simplest rule modifications required developer intervention, leading to delayed updates and a slow change management cycle due to their dependency. That's where Studio Home, SAP Build's latest decision management application, comes in. With the new Studio Home, business users can now view, edit, and maintain decisions from a dedicated user interface that only shows the decision artifacts within a project. Options such as inputs, outputs, reorder, create new rule are not present in this user interface, showing only the options that are relevant to the business users. With a one-click button, they can release a patch version of the project and deploy it after making the rule updates. This application comes with a design console that shows any error or warning message during the release and deployment of a project, and a version history option to navigate and view the previous versions of the decision artifacts in the project. The Studio Home application can be configured to be accessed from a workzone tile. The instructions to configure the application in the workzone site is provided in the help portal. On top of Studio Home's release, there are enhancements to the expression editor in decision tables, making quick edits faster and more intuitive than ever before. With a new Studio Home, business users can now take the ownership of maintaining and owning the decision artifacts independently. By simplifying the process, reducing dependencies, and accelerating change management, decision management is more accessible and efficient than ever. Check out this blog post from Sheshadri Srinivas to find out all the details about Studio Home and the enhancements to the expression editor for decisions.
Hello everyone. We have almost come to the end of this month, and we thank all the participants who have already completed the ABAP Developer Challenge. We still have a couple of days to finish the ABAP Developer Challenge and earn a badge of completion. In June, we get to escape our brand new room for SAP Cloud Application Programming Model in SAP Community Escape House. This room will be unlocked next week for the participants to attempt the SAP Developer Challenge. In order to escape the CAF room, you would have to create a CAF project, create some custom code, and perform some testing. On your way out, you will also learn about remote debugging. In order to participate, you just need to use your user ideas and input and start the challenge and explore the story that unfolds. Link to the SAP Community Escape House are included in the description. Wishing you all the best for your challenge and happy learning.
SAP has announced that its SAP UI5 Web Development Framework now complies with the latest Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, WCAG 2.2, and SAP UI5 version 1.136, and UI5 Web Components version 2.9.0. These updates enhance features like focus visibility and assistive technology, ensuring better usability for people with disabilities and improve the user experience overall. If you're interested to learn more of what kind of changes have been made to the SAP UI5 and UI5 Web Components frameworks, be sure to check out the link in the description below. Happy coding!
Hola, SAP developers. I'm always amazed by how accessible SAP learning content is nowadays. Long gone are the days that the only way you could learn about an SAP technology was by attending a course at a training center. I just want to highlight two new learning offerings that are available to all of you developers out there who are interested in learning about integration. There is the new SAP Integration Suite Basic Trial, which provides you a ready-made environment where you can get familiar with a few capabilities, like, for example, cloud integration, API management, and integration assessment. It should take you around an hour, 30 minutes to complete it. So go ahead and check it out. Also, there's a new mission in the tutorial system, which helps you get started with SAP Integration Suite Advanced Event Mesh. It covers everything from creating an instance to connecting to an S/4HANA cloud system, getting familiar with the main components of the service, and how you can integrate with other products like cloud integration and SAP Build Process Automation. All the content is freely available. It is just a matter of dedicating time to learn. So go ahead and enjoy the learning. Happy learning!